Hey, what's up everyone? This is Aaron from Studio 3B. The last video I posted, I talked about some common development tools, and one of which was Homebrew. Homebrew is your Homebrew package manager. Yeah. And we talked about this and basically how it's a useful tool for web development and any other development on the Mac OS operating system. So I got a question from a buddy of mine saying, well, does this work on Windows? And that's a good question. And I really wanted to just spend this video investigating that question. So sit tight. So now what I would do is ask Google and I would say Homebrew for Windows. Homebrew for Windows. Yes, you need this Windows subsystem for Linux. So Homebrew does work on Linux, and apparently there is a subsystem on Windows that you can install that will give you a Linux-like interaction with the command line. And I wanted to walk through me trying to install this on my own Windows operating system and see if it works. So Homebrew does come for Linux, and it'll work on the Windows subsystem. So let's look at the Windows subsystem. What is the Windows subsystem for Linux? It looks like it gives you most of the command line tools, utilities, and applications directly on Windows, unmodified, without the overhead of traditional virtual machine or dual boot setup. So obviously, by the way, I am in a virtual machine in Windows. I'm actually in Windows, and I'm going to set up this Windows subsystem for Linux, so it's going to give me a Linux-like interaction with the operating system. This will allow me to install Homebrew theoretically. Let's see if it all works. So let's see, where do we download this? Here's install. And simplified install for Windows Insiders. Well, I'm not a Windows Insider. So what do? Manual install. All right. First, you must enable Windows Subsystem for Linux optional feature before you install any Linux distributions on Windows. So let's go to this. Open PowerShell as an administrator and run. Here's PowerShell. Run as administrator. All right. Attempting to perform initialize default drives operation on file system provider failed. I'm just going to ignore that message. Let's see if this command works. Oh, it's doing something. Enabling feature. It's always a good sign when it says the operation completed successfully. All right. Check requirements for running WSL2. 64. All right. Version 1903 or higher with build. All right. Well, I think I am up to date on my... I'm up to date. How do I find out my build number? Oh, okay. Here we go. All right. I have version 20H2 and OS build 19042. So 19042. So I think we're compatible. Great. Download the Linux kernel update package. Okay. So we installed Windows Subsystem for Linux. Enable virtual machine feature. So let's copy this command. Let's run PowerShell as an administrator. And let's run that command. Restart. Alrighty then. We're up to step 3. Okay, we did steps 1, 2, and 3. Now let's download the Linux kernel update package. I've downloaded that already. Now it should let me install it. Okay, so we ran that. Now set WSL2 as your default version. I'm just going to run it as administrator just in case. Okay. Now install the Linux distribution of choice. Oh, interesting. You can install your Linux distribution of choice. So when it comes to Linux, I love Linux. I use the Linux operating system for web servers and development tasks and everything. So my favorite Linux distribution is Debian. It is the most stable in my opinion. Go to the Microsoft Store and look at this. This is amazing. This is amazing. Get Debian. You own this app. Awesome. It's downloading it. I have a fast internet connection, by the way, so don't be surprised if it takes longer to download for you. Just got installed. Check it out. Okay, let's try launch it. First time you launch the newly installed Linux distribution, a console window will open and be asked to wait a minute for the two files to decompress and start on your PC. All future launches should take less than a second. Awesome. Here's Debian. Installing. Taking a minute. Oh no, it failed with error.
A few moments later.
Okay, guys, wow, after a long little diversion, I just figured out why I wasn't able to get Windows Subsystem for Linux to work right away. I am working in a Windows virtual machine, which is on my Mac OS operating system. So the steps that I had to take to get this to work is under System Processor. In my settings, I had to enable nested VTX AMDV. I had to restart my virtual machine. Then I had to enable programs and features in the control panel. I had to go to programs, turn Windows features on or off. I had to enable Hyper-V platform and services. I had to enable Hyper-V management tools. Then I also had to run this command in PowerShell. So basically I'm running Linux inside of Windows, which is inside of Mac. So I had to go take a couple extra steps. If you are just running Windows on your desktop, all you really need to do is enable VTX in your BIOS. So you shouldn't have the same hiccups that I had. So look, it looks like I have Debian being installed. So I'm going to come up with a username. I'm going to call it Studio3B. I'm going to give it a password. And wow, look at that. I have Debian installed. So let's see if I can use the basic commands. Let's see where I am. All right. I wonder where this folder is located. Oh, another step I had to take for my virtual machine is I had to use version 1 of Windows Subsystem for Linux. They're telling us version 2 is the latest. So if you're just running Windows right on your hardware, try version 2. What I'm trying to figure out is where is this directory created locally? Where are WSL files created? Oh, there's a WSL dollar sign path. So let's see. Oh, so I wonder if I can map the WSL. I wonder if I can map this right as the drive, app network drive. Interesting. Let's do L for Linux. Wow. So look, this is my Linux subsystem. And if I go to home, that's interesting. So let's do what I said in the previous video and install Sublime Text Editor. Okay, so we've got Sublime Text installed. And as you can see up here, it says unregistered. That's what I was talking about in my last video. It will give you a pop-up every 6 or 8 saves asking you to register. So what I'm gonna do, I already purchased a license. I'm just gonna enter my license. All right, so I did my license and so now I have an editor. All right, so let's get into Homebrew. So let's see if Homebrew will work. Install Homebrew on Linux. Okay, let's do sudo apt update. Okay, so we need some basic foundational applications installed. Takes quite a bit of time to install this base command of build essential curl and file and git, so let's be patient. All right, now let's try to run Homebrew installation. Downloading and installing Homebrew. So while this is downloading, I'll show you the command I'm running. This is the command you run to install Homebrew. But this command won't work unless you install these packages. Got Homebrew installed and now it wants us to put it in the path, and so it tells us right here how to do it, and there's even a single command you could run. Hey, we have Homebrew installed. That's excellent. You have a Linux subsystem on Windows, you've got Homebrew installed, and you could edit your source code right on Windows. So if I just create a file, we'll call it text file, go up to here, and in our Sublime Text, we could, this is a test. And if we'll go right here and we go cat test.txt. Hey, look at that. So we have communication from Windows to Linux. So this would be a good development environment for you to work in. Let's install Node Package Manager. Node Package Manager. In my last video, I did discuss how Node Package Manager is very critical for web development in managing your JavaScript packages. So let's see if I could just guess how this is gonna go. Sudo apt install npm. Let's see if that works. Oh my gosh, it works. All right, now we have npm installed. Let's see if we could create a sample application folder. So let's say make directory test app, cd to test app, and let's npm init. We'll call it test app version 1, my test app, and sure, let's just accept all the defaults for now. Yes. And now if we look at our directory structure, we have our test app and we have our package JSON, just like I told you in our last video. And this is where it describes your application. And this is where your JavaScript libraries will be declared that you're gonna install on your application. And guys, I think that's enough for today. We installed Windows subsystem for Linux. We installed Debian operating system subsystem on Windows. We installed Homebrew right on our Debian Linux installation in Windows. And we installed Node Package Manager right in the Debian installation. That's a great start for our development environment. You can edit your files right from Sublime Text, which we also installed. You can map your Windows subsystem for Linux root directory as a drive. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that if you want more content like this, just subscribe to my channel. And if you could, click like on this video if it was at all useful for you.